Jeff Brock. You're off to Melbourne for Brock's 17th title fight.
17th fight, yeah, and he's fighting for two titles. He's going to defend his IBF youth title, and he's going to fight for
Pan Pacific IBF and WBA Oshara.
How are you feeling?
Feel good. Trained hard, so just finishing off the last bit of preparation, and feel good.
You look a bit nervous, mate.
I'm nervous, but
hello, everyone.
Yeah, well, where were the nerves coming from?
Where the nerves coming from? Your carry-on bag. Nervous, it's going to be a big fight, so, yeah.
Do you know much about your opponent, Ernest Salungao?
Yeah, I do. I've watched him a lot. And I watched him fight for the title last year, so he's a good fighter. We prepared well and are ready to go.
You're really sort of buoyed by the fact that you're on the big undercard of Horn and Zarafa?
You know, I think it's a great opportunity for me, and I'm happy to be on the card. Very excited.
Yep.
Yeah.
Hey, well, it nearly didn't happen after what happened in Thailand.
I don't think so. I think it was plenty of time for me to recover after that, and I think that happened in June or something, so there's still plenty of time for me to recover, and I have, so it's all good.
Just for all your fans, can you tell us what actually happened over there?
I just had to get testicular torsion surgery, so it's pretty painful, but you know, I was out of training for a bit, but I'm good now.
How did you do it?
I'm not sure. Woke up one day, went training, then I just had swelling, and yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Oh, good luck Saturday night. Jeff, how do you rate Brock's chances?
Oh, like I said, I'm a little nervous as well. This guy is a huge step up. Yeah, he's fought for the world title, went the distance, beaten some very good fighters. He was rated number 8 in the world. So it's a big test for Brock. Like I said, Brock and I have worked for the last few months really, really hard for this. And like I said, I think this kid's up to anything. So, let's get down there and we'll get this job done. And we're wrapped to be on the undercard of Jeff Horn, Michael Zarafa. I think Dean Lonigan has done a great job there, and we're just pretty honoured to be part of it all.
Is this Brock's biggest test?
Oh, definitely so. Oh, without doubt. Just hoping that we can keep that knockout record up, and he can just prove how good he is. You know, people always will want to say, oh, this opponent, that opponent, but Brock's put some great fighters already, and we've beaten him, and this is going to be his biggest test by far.
Is Brock the main undercard?
Yeah, Brock's the main support, yes.
So he'll be, and the next fight will be Horn and Zarafa?
That's right. Yeah.
Who do you think will win out of Horn and Zarafa?
Well, I've always thought Jeff Horn would win, but watching Michael Zarafa train the last couple of occasions when I seen him spar in Sydney, he was super, super impressive. I think if you can take that form into the ring, it could be a huge upset.
With blokes like Brock, is boxing in good hands?
I definitely say there's more than just Brock. There's Liam Wilson. There's so many good fighters. The Maloney brothers. There's so many good fighters out there. And I just say it's all about promoting them. Right. And I think Dean Lonigan's doing that.
Without looking too far ahead, where does Brock go after Bendigo?
Well, I think that if he wins his fight and wins it the way I think he will, he'll be in the top 10 in the world. So it's a big step up. And we just got to make sure we're not in a huge rush. We just got to make sure we just take it one step at a time. And hopefully, in a year and a half, he'll be fighting for the world title and be victorious.
Good luck, boys.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.